All right, we're going to be talking about Murph today. So for those who don't know Murph, it is traditionally done in CrossFit affiliates on Memorial Day. Memorial Day is a day where we're supposed to remember all those who sacrificed their life in the military or involved with the military. All right, so as much as most people think Memorial Day is weekend, days off, barbecue, there is a flip side to it. It's kind of important to remember it. Now, that doesn't mean not go out, enjoy the weekend, have your barbecue, hang out with family and friends, get great sales at different stores, but at the same time, remember kind of what that weekend's all about, especially that Monday Memorial Day. So in CrossFit, we honor all those people by doing Murph. So Murph, if you've seen Lone Survivor, he is the guy that goes up and calls on the radio and gets shot, and that's how Marcus Luttrell, I believe I'm saying his name correctly, maybe not, ends up being the only one to survive those circumstances. Now, in hindsight, Murph was actually kind of famous before that as well. Now, fast forward, there's a foundation, there's a battleship, I believe, named after him, a couple different documentaries, and a book. So there's a lot of stuff out there about this legend named Murph. And this was his favorite workout. He called it body armor at the time because that's what he would wear. It was a 1 mile run, 100 pull-ups, 200 push-ups, 300 squats, and a 1 mile run. Now, before you're like 100 pull-ups, 200 push-ups, you can partition that middle section any way you want. So the 100, 200, 300, split it up any way you want. Now in the world of CrossFit, what they recommend, after they renamed him to Murph, they say, hey, wear a weight vest, 20 pounds for the guys, 14 pounds for the women. We've had some people accidentally wear a 30 pound and a 20 pound, everything like that. And we also have some people coming in wearing a lot of their gear just so it kind of mimics what body armor really was like. All right, so we have a couple rules when it comes to hero workouts here, and it's just that you can't complain or whine, and you can't quit unless something's falling off you. So the workout, the way we pace it, well, first off, the first run, the first mile, don't get sucked into that trap of running super hard right away. You want to kind of, let's say you have like a 7 minute mile, you should probably come in at like 7.5 to 7:45 or so. If you have a 6 minute mile, you can come in around that 6.5, 6:45 and still be pretty good, maybe all the way up to 7. But we don't want to blow out that first mile because you're going to suffer more as you go. We want to stay below threshold. The way we split it up is by push-ups, because usually push-ups are where people start to get beat up and slow down. So I have okay push-ups, we do 20 rounds of 5 pull-ups, 10 push-ups, 15 squats. Those 10 push-ups, if you know you're going to have to break after you get like 5 rounds in, I suggest breaking early. So break before broken. So if you know you're going to have to start going 5-5 on round 3, 4, and 5 of this, break that way right away. So whatever you think you're going to be 4 or 5 rounds in, start that way so you don't hit that threshold point early on. Now, if you think you have pretty good push-ups, if someone asks you, yeah, I got pretty good push-ups, as in 20 plus push-ups in a row are not a problem for you, all right? We can go 5 rounds of 10 pull-ups, 20 push-ups, 30 squats, into 10 rounds of 5 pull-ups, 10 push-ups, 15 squats. Now, I personally like this one, especially if you're okay at pull-ups, because usually, okay at push-ups, not okay, pretty good, I'm doing good today. Because I like to get half that workout done in 5 rounds, and then I feel a lot better because I can keep moving on the 5, 10, 15. Now, if you're a monster at push-ups, people think, man, every time there's a push-up workout, they think of you, and you're great at them, just go 10 rounds, 10, 20, 30. Now, if you're that person in the gym where there's like a workout with Tabata push-ups, and you're almost getting 15 plus push-ups every single Tabata round, and you're crazy at those push-ups, like, man, that guy's a real freak with them, try going 5 rounds of 20 pull-ups, 40 push-ups, and 60 squats. And again, no matter which one you're picking for your pacing so you can just keep moving, we want to make sure you break before broken. So if you're doing 10 rounds of 10, 20, 30, those 10 pull-ups, you know after a couple of rounds you're going to be going 5-5 or 6-4, start that way. It might not seem to make sense right now, but as you go through the workout, you'll be able to hold that steady pace longer, and you'll be passing by the people that are sitting there shaking out, resting for a lot longer. Because this workout's really about what is my pace that I can sustain. It's not about who comes out and wins the mile and wins the first half of the pull-ups, push-ups, and squats. Now, when you get to that last mile, we always recommend that people negative split. So what I mean by negative split is, because we have a mile turnaround point, so you run 800 meters out, run 800 meters back, excuse me. So at that turnaround point, your time going out should be slower than your time coming back. All right. What we see a lot of people do is they come out last mile, let's hit it. And they run really hard out and they fall apart all the way back. We want you to know that when you hit that halfway point, you can pick it up and run faster on the way in. And this is the best way we have found to get the best time in Murph and not fall apart during it. Okay. So again, that first mile is the trap. Don't fall for it. Break before broken on all the gymnastics portion of it, and that last mile, set yourself up the negative split. Because you're going to notice that first 400, after doing all those squats and everything, those legs aren't working too well. But set yourself up for success, right? This workout is about honoring someone who knows how to persevere, sacrifice, and really worked hard on some grueling workouts and grueling conditions in the military. I don't think the best way to honor them is to go really fast and fall apart and then complain about it. All right, so I hope this helps your MRF experience. If this is your first year doing it, drop the reps in half. Don't go crazy on it right away. All right, if you have any questions, love to hear about your MRF times and how you did it and how your gym kind of honors fallen heroes. Talk to you guys soon.